Welcome back, everyone. All right, so are you ready? Forget everything you know about chicken pot pie, because our good friend Catherine St. John, chef and owner of Western Reserve School of Cooking, is here to make us a Bot Boy Dutch. It's really a game changer, so you say.
Well, yeah, and I had never heard of it. And then
I haven't either.
And then over New Year's, we went to Lancaster County in Pennsylvania to meet our son halfway, and his girlfriend was with him, and we were at her grandmother's house, and she made this one night that's called Bot Boy, and she said, I'm making pot pie, and so I'm thinking that's going to be chicken.
Pie.
Yeah, it's going to have a crust and all this stuff, and she brings out, or she makes these handmade noodles, which we're going to show you, and it's just a really rich chicken soup, and it has saffron in it, and then we have these thicker, bigger, square-cut noodles that just make it kind of a really comforting type thing.
Whenever my kids are sick, they always say, Mom, will you make me chicken soup with those really thick noodles? There's nothing quite like those thick
So we're going to start,
like steak.
The soup itself, you're going to take a whole chicken, cover it in water, onions, celery, carrots, you know, cook it, poach it, take the meat off the bones.
The white and the dark meat?
Right, and then you can throw the bones back in, cook it longer, strain it, and then I put in fresh carrots, celery, and onions. And return the chicken to there, add the saffron.
So that, my grandmother used to put the bones back in. That really does make a difference.
Oh, yeah. So the noodles themselves are pretty straightforward. Flour, it's 1 cup of flour for every egg, and then you add an extra egg. So this is 2 cups of flour, 3 eggs. You're gonna need a little water if you have to bring it together. But you're just gonna sort of make this dough, and this is the dough here once it's done.
What's the Bot Boy mean?
You know, as near as I can tell, it was brought over actually from the Germans, and it just has to do with this, you know, these thicker noodles, and I'm sure you'll have a lot of people out there in
the
watching
land. You're gonna want this recipe,
that have probably more authentic versions of this.
Well, it got our attention.
Yeah, I like to put peas in mine at the end.
Oh, sure.
So anyway, you're just gonna kind of bring all this together as it's soft dough, so we're just gonna.
So once you have that, then we're gonna
fast
forward to this. Okay.
Right, you're gonna knead it into this, and then we're just gonna roll this out. And traditionally, you know, I could take this same dough and put it through a pasta machine and make fettuccine or linguine or anything like that. But this is a thicker, wide cut noodle.
Okay.
And we just wanna get it. You know, about a quarter of an inch thick. And sometimes you might have to just sort of let this rest a little bit. And I haven't actually taught this at the school yet, but like I said, my son's girlfriend, Caitlin, made this the first night we were there.
So I'm sure she scored some good points with
there you,
right?
You're
like, okay, great, I love her.
Yeah.
That's great.
Well, no, it's in her grandma's kitchen, and you know,
that's
she
really
was just
neat,
sort of just rolling this out. And then I like to use, you can use a pastry wheel. I like to use a fluted one.
Okay.
And then you're just gonna cut it in strips, just right down like that. Just like so.
That's it.
You cut it back this way. All right, so now you've got these thicker noodles. You can finish that part off if you want.
I will.
And then you're just gonna drop these in the simmering stock.
Mine aren't nearly as nice as yours.
Okay. And these take, you know, probably about 10 minutes or so to cook, and you can just drop them right in.
Okay.
And they're gonna soak up the stock and everything as it sits. So you can actually, it'll freeze okay. The leftovers, you can then just add more stock to it if you want.
Okay.
And just go from there. But then we're just gonna bring this up to a simmer. And then we have our soup, finished soup right here, which we'll bring up and you can give it a shot. This'll cure what ails you.
Where are my friends?
I like to put the peas in right at the end, or you can just stick them in the bowl.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's so good.
And it's a nice homemade stock.
Oh, it's not good. I don't think you'll want
you
any.
No,
I'll have your portion.
You can throw some peas in there if you want.
Okay.
You want some peas in there?
Yes, peas.
The peas and carrots.
Peas, there should be.
Oh, this is just absolutely delicious. It's everything and more.
Yeah, it's really great. And, you know, we do all kinds of things like this at the school. Right now, we actually have a ton of kids' classes we're doing. parent-child classes. We have a whole Sunday series called Kitchen Boot Camp for Kids.
Kitchen Boot Camp.
Okay.
And I just finished Sunday. We did knife skills for kids. So I had 12 kids running
Very
around
good.
With knives.
Oh, boy.
Doing Mexican food.
We have all the information on our wonderful cooking school, the great classes for kids, and this recipe
Yum.
For Bot Boy.
I've never had broth like this before.
Yeah, it's homemade.
Why is it the
it's
homemade.
It's just nice
I know it's good to be your husband, I'm telling you.
Yeah. Way to go, Carl.
That's why Carl's over there smiling.
Fox 8 Recipe Box is brought to you by Dean Supply.